Currently, multiple news articles are making the rounds which all claim that after more than a century of no eruptions, Alaska's Iliamna volcano is suddenly rumbling. And, normally, I would be more than happy to share with my audience that a form of volcanic unrest is ongoing at a remote but picturesque United States volcano that few people have ever seen. Only one problem. There wasn't actually any true volcanic unrest, although the volcano was truly rumbling for a time, and it seems that many readers of these articles are misinterpreting what exactly happened. As a quick reference, Alaska's Iliamna volcano is located 137 miles southwest of Anchorage on the western side of the Cook Inlet. Iliamna erupts quite infrequently, having last erupted in 1876, and while no one lives right next to the volcano, any of its future eruptions have a high potential of disrupting regional air traffic for a time. However, Iliamna has one particular distinguishing feature, and I promise this is relevant for the cause of the recent rumbling, as several chunks of Iliamna's edifice show textbook depictions of strong hydrothermal alteration, which has turned rock shades of yellow, orange, red, and brown. For reference, when rocks are hydrothermally altered, the movement of rising hydrothermal fluids and gases replaces harder rock types such as andesite with more brittle rock units and minerals such as kaolinite. As a result, what was originally a fairly stable series of slopes eventually became unable to fully hold up the rock adjacent to and above hydrothermally altered regions, causing semi-frequent landslides and avalanches to occur. These debris avalanches, as they are called, seem to be a mixture of about 50% ice and 50% rock, and sometimes are quite large and lengthy, traveling multiple miles. For example, one particularly large debris avalanche on June 21, 2019, involving 1.5 million cubic meters of rock, traveled 4 miles or 6.4 kilometers, with part of the slide exceeding speeds of 150 miles per hour. However, these events are by no means rare, with larger detected events occurring at least once in 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2023. Every time one of these events occurs, including often before the main landslide happens, the ground continuously rumbles, as many larger landslides start with precursory slower or less voluminous smaller landslides. Such landslides are most common during the summer months, particularly June and July. As you might have guessed, this same process occurred briefly for a few hours on June 15, 2025, causing brief rumbling, which all of these articles are specifically referencing. I have located at least four landslides which occurred on that day, which traveled as much as 1,550 meters or 5,085 feet from their source. Compared to landslides in prior years, these are comparatively small in volume, likely involving less than a combination of 200,000 cubic meters of material. No additional seismic signals indicating additional similar volume landslides have since been detected. Since the aforementioned avalanches occurred during the summer, were within the normal size range of slides at Iliamna, and did not occur alongside any other unusual activity, nothing truly abnormal is ongoing at this volcano. It is merely activity as usual. The last time Iliamna truly showed signs of unrest was in 1996, when a magma dike intrusion occurred beneath the volcano which failed to reach the surface, therefore not resulting in an eruption. The only two volcanoes actually at a raised alert level in Alaska are the erupting Great Sitkin volcano and the Mount Spurr volcano, which is still showing some but decreasing signs of unrest. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.